Today we are here in Partha Dental Billandur, Bangalore branch, and today we will be discussing few topics about dentistry. So now, starting with the introduction of Partha Dental. So Partha Dental is a largest and fastest growing chain in South India. It has around 86 clinics, among which Billandur branch is one of them. So let's have a look at the clinic. This is the reception area. This is the reception area where patients wait, and this is the front office desk. He is our front office receptionist. So how is the records and everything maintained here?
Yeah, everything is going on good. We enter OP registrations of the patients, and we maintain all their records. What are the treatments done? And we pay all the bills, we give them the receipts where no issues happens, and everything is going on very well in Partha Dental. Partha Dental is giving us very good, like.
Okay, so now coming to the consultation. Here we are meeting our doctor, Dr. Shruti. She is the MDS maxillofacial prosthodontist.
Hi, myself Dr. Shruti. I am also part of Partha family, and I am a maxillofacial prosthodontist, and I deal with all the replacements of the tooth and also the maxillofacial structures.
So this is the consultation room, and this is our consultation chair where patients come and meet us, and here we hear their complaints, their problems, we record them, and we tell them their treatment plan. So how do we start our treatment plan? Will after explaining about the, after listening about the patient's chief complaint and everything, if it is required, we advise them an x-ray. So now we'll see what type of x-ray we take. So this is an OPG machine. This OPG machine, in simple words, we say a full mouth x-ray we take. Now I will show you here a full mouth x-ray. This is a full mouth x-ray or an OPG taken of a patient. Here we can see all the teeth of his full mouth can be seen here, and whatever problems is there, radiographically we can analyze them. Apart from that, while taking OPG or x-ray, we provide these lid aprons to the patient so that any harmful radiation, excessive radiation, is not reaching to the patient. Our patient is protected from the harmful or excessive radiations. Apart from that, we also have an IOPA machine. So this is an IOPA machine through which we take x-rays or IOPAs. IOPAs, in simple or general term, what we give to patients normally are small x-rays. In very simple terms, I can explain you that it is very small x-rays of a particular tooth that we can take by this IOPA machine. Now this is our consultation. Now this is our treatment room bar. Here we can see this is our dental chair. And these are the instruments. These instruments are packed into pouches. These instruments are sterile first. They are cleaned and they are sterilized in an autoclave machine. I will also be showing you what is an autoclave machine and how do we do that. So let's have a look at the autoclave machine. This is our lab where we clean and sterile all our instruments. So here we can see this is an autoclave machine. In this, the instruments are cleaned. These are the instruments which are already clean. These instruments are cleaned, and then after that they are put into this machine. They are put into this machine for 15 minutes. This machine has a temperature set of 121 degrees Celsius. And after that, after removing these instruments from here, we pack them into such pouches. These are pouches, specialized pouches, in which the autoclaved or sterile instruments are packed. And after that, we remove fresh instruments in front of patients when required. Now, so we'll talk about Partha Dental more before starting about the topics I would like to say today. So Partha Dental is the largest and fastest growing dental clinic in over three states in South India. So we have around 86 dental clinics in South India, and we are planning of more dental clinics also. There are around 12 dental clinics in Bangalore. There are around 40 dental clinics in Andhra Pradesh and around 30 dental clinics in Telangana. So this all has been possible due to hard work and motivation of Dr. P.V. Partha Sarathy, who has started Partha Dental Clinic 20 years back. So 20 years back, he started in Tirupati, and since then he has been working hard for spreading best dental care to the patient. The main motive of Partha Dental is only that we provide and enhance best dental care to the patients. For us, our patients are the first priority to provide them as much as possible the best dental care. So now we will discuss about the topics. So as I told you, we will discussing about few informative topics about the patient. I am an oral and maxillofacial surgeon, so I will be discussing few surgical topics also and few non-surgical treatment procedures also. So the most common thing which I see, or the most common thing which I find in my patients for surgical procedure, for which young patients come, are wisdom tooth impaction. So what is a wisdom tooth? What is a wisdom tooth impaction, and why it is so common nowadays in patients? So talking about wisdom tooth, there are three molars in each side of a human body. There are teeth, both mandibular and maxillary, upper arch and lower arch. So in each side there are four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. So in each side there are three molars. The last molar is called a wisdom tooth. So I will show you how does it look. I hope you can see in this. See, this is a photo of an full mouth x-ray. So here you can see the last tooth in each side is the wisdom tooth. I hope you can see it clearly. I am trying to show you. Yeah, this is an OPG. Yeah, correct Karthik, you are correct. This is an OPG. And in this, the last tooth which you can see is the wisdom tooth. So what happens, why most commonly the people come saying that I have a, yes, correct Karthik, it is an impacted wisdom tooth. So why it is so common nowadays? So according to evolutionary process, our jaws, as we are going on the evolution, the human being's jaws are becoming smaller and smaller. So now the last tooth usually does not have enough space to erupt, to come out. So when this is the situation in which the last tooth does not have enough space to erupt, in that situation what happens is the tooth gets stuck inside the bone. Now there is no place for the tooth to get erupted. The tooth is stuck inside the bone. Whenever it tries to erupt, then that time patient will have pain. The patients will complain that I have swelling here, I cannot bite, the pain is radiating from last tooth till my head, till my neck, till my ear. This is because there is a nerve, a small nerve which supplies the facial area from half of the lower jaw. So what happens is that when the tooth tries to erupt, it pressurizes on the nerve. Because of that, patient has pain and patient has swelling, because usually what happens, there is lodgement of food in that area. So because of that, patient will have swelling in that area. So I'll show you another photo of an impacted wisdom tooth. This is an impacted wisdom tooth. Okay, the last one, can you see the last lower The last one is an impacted wisdom tooth. Yes, it is having, the situation is called pericoronitis. Yes, Karthik, you are correct. The situation is called as pericoronitis. So, pericoronitis, what does it mean? It means that peri means surrounding, corona means around the tooth. Coronitis. Itis means inflammation. So any inflammation which is surrounding around the tooth is called pericoronitis. So usually why does it happen? Whenever the tooth tries to erupt, it the surrounding area becomes swollen, the gums become swollen, and there is a flap kind of thing. I'll show you here in this. In photo, this you can see, there is a flap kind of thing. In the green arrow you can see, there is a flap kind of thing here. So here, there is food lodgement beneath that flap, beneath that tissue, beneath that gums. There is again and again food lodgement. So because of that, what happens? There is inflammation and there is pus formation. So patient will have a continuous complaint that for 2 months or 3 months I will be fine, and suddenly one day the pain will come. So I would like to tell you, when there is no space for the wisdom tooth to erupt, then this situation is recurrent. Again and again it can happen, and it is recurrent. So then we, what do we do? What a patient should do if such situation is there? First thing a patient should do is that should consult a doctor. First thing, after consulting a doctor, a dentist, a maxillofacial surgeon, what they should do is they should get an x-ray done. A doctor gets an x-ray for that person, or an OPG. In an OPG, the situation of the tooth is completely visible. In that we can see how is the status of the bone, how much bone is available, or how much bone is covering over the tooth. If there is space available, then the tooth can erupt. Then we can follow another procedure that I will tell you later, what are the procedures. If space is not available, then in that situation what do we do? In that situation we will have to extract the tooth. So I told you two scenarios. One scenario is in which we do not need to extract the tooth if space is available. One scenario is in which we have to extract the tooth. So talking about the first scenario, in which we do not have to extract the tooth, that procedure is called as operculectomy. In operculectomy, what do we do? In operculectomy, the only thing we do is we do not extract the tooth. We just make space in this gum area. We just remove little bit of gum around the tooth so that the tooth can erupt. If the bone space is available for the tooth to erupt and only the gums are the problem, we just remove the gum around the tooth so that the tooth can erupt freely. This process is called as operculectomy. Second process, which I told you, if bone is completely covering the tooth or if there is no sufficient space for the tooth to erupt, in that situation we will have to extract the tooth. That procedure, many patients, when they come to me, when I explain to them that I have to extract the tooth, then they say, no doctor, I do not want any procedure to extract the tooth. It will affect my eyesight. This is a myth. First thing to tell you, this is a myth. Any tooth extraction does not affect your eyesight. This is a myth, because of which many patients keep on suffering on the pain. They will not undergo the treatment. Such recurrent situation has to be treated, and in case if there is pus or infection, it has to be treated as early as possible. Otherwise, it can lead to other consequences. So how do we extract a wisdom tooth? So before starting any procedure, any surgical procedure, I would like to explain you the steps so that it becomes more clear to you and more easier to you to decide. First thing, before starting any procedure in Partha Dental, what we follow is that we use all instruments in sterile and aseptic condition. As I showed you that we have a properly made sterilization room in which we sterile the instrument so that all the bacteria and all everything, fungi, virus, everything, whatever spores are there, they all get destroyed. And then with that instrument, the first basic procedure should be aseptic condition. Then second thing, the patient which is, he is concerned more about is the pain. They ask me, will it pain during the procedure? So we put a small injection of anesthesia. so that the anesthesia, when it starts working, the area of around the tooth and half of your this area, jaw area, becomes numb so that you do not experience any pain during the procedure. After the anesthesia starts working, then we start the procedure. In that also, what we do, if there is bone covering around the tooth, we have to just trim a little bit, around 1 mm, only 1 mm, not more than that of the bone, so that the tooth becomes the area around the tooth becomes loose, and so that the tooth can come out easily. This is the surgical procedure of extraction of a wisdom tooth. So why did I emphasize so much on explaining this? Because my main motive behind this was that many patients, they skip the treatment plan when they hear that they require extraction. So they land up further problems. There can be, why, how they land up into further problems? The human face, there are many spaces connected inside. Each muscle and tissue are connected inside with each other. There are many spaces. So if there is an infection in one area, the infection can spread to another area very easily. So if there is a small infection in the wisdom tooth here, suppose if there is a small infection or wisdom tooth, he is having radiating pain, the infection can spread to the neck, the infection can spread towards the eye, the infection can spread in this whole cheek area. So I'll show you one photo of a case in which the person is having infectious space infection. So here you can see this person. This person is having a space infection. This person is having a cheek or space infection. You can see here clearly. This usually these situations are due to infection related to teeth. This is called odontogenic infection or teeth related infection. In such situation, this is more worse situation. Another photograph of a patient. You can see this is more worse situation, okay. And there is one more photograph in which in the lower part you can see the swelling. In the lower part you can see here, this is also due to the tooth related problems. So if we leave the problems, if we do not treat the problems, then what happens? Then such, we can land up into such situation, we can land up into more serious problems. And the spaces which are in the face area, they are connected to the chest area, they are connected towards more deeper into the deeper organs of the body. So why do we say that you should take dental treatment seriously? This is the reason why do we say, because your mouth, you should not ignore any dental problem or any oral problem, because your mouth is the thing which connects to your whole body, believe it or not, even to your brain. So anyhow, I explained about wisdom tooth and I have explained about operculectomy or non-surgical treatment plan of a wisdom tooth. I have explained about surgical plan of the wisdom tooth. Now coming to another topic, one more problem for which patients come to me, which I see commonly, is that in old people, in old aged people who wear dentures, I have seen in that their denture will not retain properly, or they will have continuous pain when they wear that denture. Why does that happen? That happens due to sharp bony spicules or sharp bony projections into that area. I will show you one picture. So this is the picture of here. You can see here is a sharp bony spicule or projection. So such projection or sharp bony spicule, due to which patients are not able to wear their denture. They will fear of wearing their denture. They will say, no, I cannot wear, or I cannot eat, because whenever I wear my denture, my bones start paining or my gums start paining. So I would like to say, for such problems also. If for old patients, this is my message that please do not ignore such problems. If there is a continuous pressure on your jaws or when you wear denture, please visit a dentist, please visit a doctor. So what can be the treatment for that? A very simple treatment is there for that. What we do is we locate the bony spicule. Only by touching we can come to know that the bony spicule is where it is. We locate the bony spicule and after locating it, we can just after giving a small anesthesia injection, after the area is numb, what we can do is we can just remove the or file out the bony spicule very gently. So it is very small procedure. Some old age patient will avoid it. They will think that it is a big procedure or how it can be treated. So I would like to tell them that there is no need to bear that pressure. So you can just go to a dentist and you can just when you go to a dentist, they will just remove that bony shard spicule, and then after that you will be relieved with that pain. Now there is a question from Mr. Dev. If our gums are weak, what procedure should we take to get rid of this? So, and if gum is bleeding, is there, what should we do for that? Okay. Mr. Dev, I would like to say that about bleeding gums. What is the main reason for bleeding gums? The gums, why do they bleed? See, around every tooth, in a human being, it is a natural phenomena that a debris get collected. That debris is called plaque, and when it gets hardened, it is called calculus. This debris or plaque, it is a natural phenomena in every human being. Okay, it doesn't go out by itself on brushing. So for that, how you can get it treated is that you can go and visit a dentist. What happens when you leave it? Why do your gum bleed? Your main question is that. So what happens is that when you do not get removed that your clear plaque or calculus, when you do not get it removed, then what happens is that the plaque or calculus or that debris, in simple words, that is a nidus or nest for the bacteria to survive. Those bacteria, when they survive there, after surviving there, what do? Is that they start increasing the infection around the gums. And because of that debris, the gums start leaving their attachments. They start receding and the gums lose their attachments. So this is the reason why the gums become weak. First and basic reason is the accumulation of plaque or debris. Now when patient touches the gums or when they brush their teeth, that time they will experience bleeding gums. This is a very common problem. This is because people avoid that general cleaning of their teeth with a dentist. This cleaning procedure is called as scaling. So in every 6 to 8 months, every person should go to a dentist and they should get a generalized cleaning or scaling of their teeth. So this scaling is a prophylactic procedure. What does prophylactic mean? Prophylactic means preventive procedure. This leads to prevention of other further consequences which can happen if you do not get treated, if you do not remove those debris or plaque or calculus. So another question from Ms. Shruti is, how many days of rest do I need after wisdom tooth extraction? Will I be able to get back to work immediately? So I would like to tell that yes, after wisdom tooth extraction you can go to work. On the same day, avoid going to work, because on the same day if you have undergone a surgical procedure, then you should avoid traveling, you should avoid going to work. You can go, but under the medications, if you feel fine, then only you go. Do not need to strain yourself. This is my advice. So from the second day onwards you can go to work, but for 1 day or 2 days try taking rest, and you will be fine. Around after 5 to 7 days the gums heal after extraction, so you can go to work normally. So now coming to another topic. So I told you about few of the surgical topics. Now I will tell you few of the few of the non-surgical topic which I see commonly. So in that non-surgical topic which I see very commonly, and personally I have seen many patients, in even in literate people or illiterate people, anybody, I have seen a situation which happens due to eating betel nut or supari or pan gutka. So it is very common. Even I should say that even literate people also, I have seen, well educated people also have seen, they have this habit of eating betel nut. So this situation is it leads to something called as oral submucous fibrosis. Oral submucous fibrosis is a condition in which over a time period gradually your mouth opening decreases. You experience that your mouth opening has become lesser and lesser and lesser. So why does it happen? What is the meaning of oral submucous fibrosis? So oral means mouth, submucous means beneath the tissue, beneath the skin. Fibrosis means stiffening of the tissues of your mouth or your cheek or your oral area or your mouth area. This is oral submucous fibrosis. Now why does it happen, especially with betel nut? The reason for that is the betel nut or areca nut, it is the chemical name of betel nut, it contains a chemical called as arecoline. This arecoline acts on the chemically, it acts on the tissues of the skin of the mouth, and they make such changes in the mouth so that the mouth becomes more stiffer. The tissues become, they lose their elasticity, they become more stiffer. So what happens is that now slowly, gradually over a time period, the patient's mouth opening decreases. Recently, I had a patient, I saw a patient recently who had this problem, and he did not even know that he had this problem. He came to me with a simple problem of toothache. But when I was checking him, when I was palpating his mouth, I found that the buccal area, the cheek region, were very stiff. I found that. So I told him, I asked him, do you have a habit of eating gutka or supari or betel nut? So he told me that from past 6 months he had this habit of eating betel nut or gutka. So betel nut or gutka in past 6 months, it is very fast. Usually I had seen till now in 10 years, 15 years, but now I'm seeing that very fast also it affects for some people. If it is so fast affecting you, then you should be really worried about your health, because oral submucous fibrosis is something to be worried about. It is a precancerous condition. Precancerous condition, I would like to repeat. It is a condition, it is a generalized condition before oral cancer. It is a precancerous condition. So please, if you have a habit of if you have any such habit, even in occasionally if you have a habit of eating betel nut, please leave it. It can lead to something very serious problem. What are the common symptoms which patient comes with if he has oral submucous fibrosis? The common symptoms is that they have burning sensation on eating spicy food. They complain that whenever they eat something spicy, they have that burning sensation, and they have this recurrent vesicles, recurrent ulcers. In general words, if I say, they have recurrent ulcers, their mouth becomes stiff, their mouth opening decreases. Even in some patients I have seen, their mouth opening decreases to zero because of this situation, because of their ignorance. So please, if anyone who is watching who have this habit, please leave it. It is not good, absolutely not good for your health. Now, what can be done in cases of a person with reduced mouth opening is a question from Mr. Indrani. In such cases of reduced mouth opening, there can be surgical and non-surgical treatment both. It depends on how much is the mouth opening of the patient. There are grades or classification, that is very medical terms, that I am not going into that much detail. According to how much mouth opening is there, we can treat them surgically or we can treat them non-surgically also. We can treat them surgically with multiple dose of vitamins or by injections of corticosteroids. Mixed with a placental extract, and if you want to, then if you want to ask about how exactly surgically, then I would say that surgical method is little extensive. But yes, we can treat them surgically also in cases where there are nil or zero mouth opening or very less mouth opening which cannot be treated by non-surgical method. In such cases, what we can do is, what a surgeon does is, they loosen surgically, they loosen the cheek area, the tissue area, they loosen it, and after loosening the tissue area, we have to graft it with another tissue or skin, or there are many other options available. So these are the surgical treatment. So I would like to say to my all you folks that do not land up into such extensive situation that we have to go for surgical treatment for you. Please avoid it. Now another question is from Rajkumar. I am suffering from teeth cavity problem. Please suggest me a best treatment. Yes, I will suggest you the best treatment of teeth cavity problem. See, first thing, if you have a cavity, please visit a dentist so that the dentist or the doctor can see that what is the situation of your teeth. That can be observed by taking an x-ray of the concerned tooth. And if a normal restoration after removing the caries, if a normal restoration is sufficient, then with the help of a normal restoration, the cavity can be filled. Or if in case the cavity is deep enough or it has reached to the blood supply of the tooth. Now I'll show you a dummy tooth. I have a dummy tooth with me. I'll show you. You can see here, this is a dummy tooth, okay? This is a model of a tooth I have. In this is the upper layer. Here you can see this is the upper layer of the tooth, and this is the blood supply of the tooth. Here the red portion is the blood supply of the tooth. So whenever the infection reaches to the red blood supply of the tooth, then we have to go for root canal procedure. So what is the root canal procedure? When the infection is spread inside the root, inside the blood supply of the tooth, then what we have to do is we have to clean the infection from the roots, from the canal. These are the canals. Here you can see the red portion. These are the canals of the tooth. From these canals of the tooth, we have to clean everything, the infection, everything. And after cleaning it, we put medication in that and we fill it with some cement material which is called as gutta percha. And after filling it with that, we fill it completely till the upper layer, and if required, you can go for a crown. Or a crown, I will show you what is a crown. So this is a crown. This is a crown portion. You can see this is a crown portion. So this is a crown. It's like an artificial tooth which completely looks like your normal tooth. In Partha Dental, we have different types of crowns also available which mimic completely like your normal teeth. Okay, this is a zirconia crown which is completely like your normal tooth. So if you have a cavity or restoration, you can go for a root canal if required and for a crown placement. So do not worry if you have any cavity or any restoration required. Visit a doctor, visit us, come to us, we will treat you. Now there are many questions going on here. Many people are concerned about bleeding gums. So I have told you, for bleeding gums, please go for cleaning or scaling of your tooth. Yes. Okay. So now coming to another informative topic. Another problem for which patient visit most commonly nowadays is pain in TMJ or temporomandibular joint. What is a temporomandibular joint? The joint between the lower jaw, in very simple words I'll explain you, the joint between the lower jaw and the upper jaw is a temporomandibular joint. So many people will experience pain in this area. They will tell that I have pain. So this is a temporomandibular joint disorder. So what happens, why it is very common nowadays, and what happens when such patient come. So why, what is the reason? This I would like to explain you in detail about that, as it is very common. The most common reason nowadays is stress. The most common reason, because of our changing lifestyle, because of so much stress each and every person is going on, many people experience this temporomandibular joint pain. This is also called as myofascial pain disorder. The pain along with temporomandibular joint, they have this pain in this myofascial area. Yeah, I have a few questions here from Ashok Puli and from Mani Vardhan Chaudhary. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for watching our video. Yeah, so I was discussing about myofascial pain and temporomandibular joint pain. So why does it happen? First, discussing about temporomandibular joint. The joint is a joint between the upper and lower jaw. So in between that joint, there is a small tissue, or there is a small skin kind of material which is called disc. So there can be many reasons. There can be some deformity inside the temporomandibular joint, or there can be other reasons also, like very common reason which I told you, a stress. That is a very common reason. So it depends what problem you are undergoing. And there is one more common reason due to which patient have this temporomandibular joint problem, is that they have a habit of night while sleeping, they have a habit of grinding their teeth. This situation is called as bruxism. This is very common. People do not know about it, but when they visit a doctor for that, then they come to know that they have bruxism. We can find out when they come to us, when we see their teeth will be treated or they will be grinded. So these people have this problem of bruxism. So what we can do if a person has a temporomandibular joint problem, if they have pain in their TMJ or in this jaw, what we can do? So in such situation, first we ask the patient about their proper problem. What is there any change in their routine life? If it is a stress related, or change in their routine life, or any deficiency, nutritional deficiency in their food. So it can be treated by treating these root cause, by correcting your lifestyle, by reducing your stress. There are many medicines for stress relieving, anxiety relieving. By normal medications also it can go off. Or there are other extensive procedures also, which I will not go in detail about the surgical treatment of temporomandibular joint disorder. But if there is anything intrinsic, then it can be seen in the x-ray, and after seeing the x-ray, we come to know that whether it is required to go something extensive surgical procedure, then it can be corrected by that also. But if you have a pain in your temporomandibular joint or your this jaw, please come to a dentist visit, a doctor, or visit us, so that at least we can diagnose, we can tell you that what is your exact problem. Now, one question is from Mr. Siddharth. My age is 26. Can I adjust my front teeth? Yes, you can adjust your front teeth. You have to, again I will tell, visit an orthodontist. An orthodontist is a doctor who is a specialist of your alignment of your teeth. So, and you have to visit an orthodontist. In Partha Dental, we have specialized doctor of every branches. So, we have many orthodontists also associated with us. Visit us. The orthodontist will check your alignment of your teeth, and after checking, yes, it can be adjusted. There are many options of alignment of your teeth. Some of that are, you must have seen the conventional metallic braces. You can go for metallic braces also, or you can go for tooth colored braces also. Braces or the wire which we put into the mouth for alignment of tooth, or the very recent advancement which we are advising to patient nowadays, I will explain to you, that are called aligners. I'll show to you one of the aligners I have with me. So this is an aligner. You can see this. This is an aligner. Okay. This is a removable kind of treatment, in which the aligner is put inside the mouth. This is a custom made. Okay. So this custom made means that it is made according to your teeth, according to your arch. So this is made in a lab. They make and they give you, and you have to put it, you have to wear it for 18 to 22 hours per day, and they exert the same pressure as the braces. The good thing is that they are not visible. They are not visible completely, and until unless a person is very close to you or very closely they see with much focus, nobody can find out that you are wearing an aligner, and they exert the same pressure like a braces also. So this is the recent advancement. Yes, you can, Siddharth, you can go for adjusting your front teeth. Now coming to one question, bad breath issue solution. Bad breath issue solution by Mr. Vishal. Yes, Mr. Vishal, bad breath is also very common nowadays, and the most common reason for that, as I told you, is the collection of debris or collection of calculus or plaque around the tooth. The debris, when it collects, it gives the bacteria an area to survive, and these bacteria, due to which these bad breath happens. So the solution for this is that get your teeth cleaned, go for a scaling, go for a cleaning, your bad breath issue will be solved. There are many other questions going on. So Mr. Farhan, what is the consequences caused by eating bubble gum? Okay, eating bubble gum usually does not cause very bad consequences, but yes, one consequence I can tell you is that overeating of bubble gum or over chewing can lead into myofunctional pain disorder. As I told you, as I was explaining about temporomandibular joint or TMJ, this joint here, upper and lower joint disorder, I was explaining to you. So this overeating of bubble gum or over chewing or over usage of your muscles can lead to myofunctional pain disorder. Myofunctional pain disorder means your muscles get sore due to over usage. So in that situation, what you can do is, you can, there are muscle relaxants tablet. You can come to a doctor, you can visit a doctor. They will prescribe you muscle relaxant, few muscle relaxant. You have to avoid the over usage of your muscles for a few days, and you have to take that muscle relaxant, and you will be absolutely fine. Another question from Mr. Manivardhan is, I have a gap in between my premolar, food accumulation is my main problem. Do I have any treatment? Yes, Mr. Manivardhan, if you have a gap in between your premolar, the permanent solution for it, I would say, is that you should go for an orthodontic treatment. If there is a gap in between your premolar teeth, if you have not lost any teeth and if still there is a gap, then the permanent solution for that is you can go for orthodontic treatment, in which the gap can be closed by usage of aligners. As I showed you, these are aligners, or it can be done by usage of braces, or the general term which people say is usage of brackets or wires. So that can also help to close your gap. Or if still you do not want to go for braces treatment, then what we can do is, the gap can be closed by placement of crown on your teeth. Or what we can do is, we can place on your premolars, to close that gap, we can place a crown over the tooth, a cap over the tooth, so that we design the cap in such a way that the gap is closed. Or if you want still one more temporary solution, this is a temporary solution, this will not solve your problem permanently, but if I'm giving you another option also, if you want a temporary solution, then you can go for an intradental brush. Intradental brushes are those brushes which you can, they are right angled or 90 degree bent brushes. That brushes you can put inside, in between two teeth, and you can clean the food lodgement there. Now next question is from Indrani. I have crooked teeth. What can be done to make it look good? Yes, Mr. Indrani, we have something called smile designing. In smile designing, in cases of crooked teeth, the permanent solution which I told you, there are two options. First is orthodontic braces. If it is possible, you can go for orthodontic treatment or braces treatment or aligners treatment, so that permanently your teeth can become aligned or in one line. Or if you do not want to go for that, then you can go for smile designing, in which your whole of your crooked teeth can be made in one line with the help of crowns or caps will be placed over that. They will look like your natural teeth only, but they will be aligned in one line. Mr. Prem Sagar has asked a question, is there any treatment for bright teeth? Yes, Mr. Prem, there is a treatment for bright teeth. There is a treatment for bright teeth. What we can do is that if your teeth are having stains, if they are extrinsic stains, there are two types of stains. There are extrinsic stains or intrinsic stains. Extrinsic stains are those stains which can be removed by normal cleaning or scaling of your teeth. Intrinsic stains are such which cannot be removed by cleaning or scaling of your teeth. In that situation, you can go for teeth whitening process. In Partha Dental, we provide teeth whitening procedure also. You can go for that. That is a teeth whitening process or bleaching of your teeth. Yes, they make your teeth look brighter and whiter. Mr. Amakayu Shibu has asked me a question, but I am really very sorry, I do not understand Telugu. Please ask the question in English. Mr. Ravi has asked me, is there treatment for oral problem? Mr. Ravi, please be clear what oral problem you have. Mr. Jagdish has asked me a question, what are impacted teeth, any complications from them? Yes, Mr. Jagdish, I had explained in before also. Impacted teeth are those teeth which are embedded inside the bone, which are not able to erupt. They are partially erupted or they are completely unerupted. So such teeth can lead to many complications. First main complication which I showed you was pericoronitis. Pericoronitis means inflammation around the gums, around the impacted tooth. Other common complication which is possible is the recurrent pain into the concerned area, and the pain is referring or radiating kind of pain. The pain radiates to the ear, to the jaw, to the neck also. And more severe complication is that because of that tooth, I have a photo I will show you. Because of that tooth, there is something called cyst formation because of a wisdom tooth. So I can show you a cyst. What is a cyst? So that you can understand how serious a problem of a wisdom tooth can be. Yes, in this photo, if you are able to appreciate the photo clearly, around the last tooth, the lower last wisdom tooth, you can see there is a big black space around the last lower tooth, which is embedded inside. You can see this blackish area, this is called as a cyst. A cyst, what is a cyst? A cyst is an empty space in which it can be filled with a liquid material, a solid material, or it can be filled with a gaseous material also. And usually it is seen with a wisdom tooth. What happens when you leave the wisdom tooth like that only, you do not get it treated, and if it is continuously erupting pressure, the bone around the area is replaced by a cyst, or the cyst starts eating up the bone in very simple terms, and the bone of the area lower jaw becomes weaker. This is very common with lower wisdom tooth. So this is the more severe complication of a wisdom tooth. So if you have a wisdom tooth which does not have a chance to erupt, there is no space to erupt, please get it extracted. Mr. Gopi Krishna has asked me how much you charge for the wisdom tooth removal. Mr. Gopi Krishna, it depends on what kind of treatment is there for wisdom tooth removal, and if it is surgical, the charges are different. If it is non-surgical treatment, then the charges will be different. So you can visit any nearby clinical Partha Dental Clinic. They can tell you the charges in clear. So Mr. Amakayu has asked me the question. My age is 27 years. For front teeth, what should be the treatment? So Mr. Amakayu, if your front teeth are crooked or malaligned or they are not in one line, you can go for a permanent treatment. That permanent treatment can be alignment through braces, through brackets, or it can be through aligners. Or if you do not want any aligner, any braces, any bracket, then you can go for another treatment which is called smile designing, in which your crooked teeth can completely be designed into a way in which they can look aligned properly. You can visit any nearest Partha Dental Clinic branch. They can and you can discuss your problem with them. They will surely provide you the solution for it. Mr. Farhan has asked me what are benefits of dental implant surgery. Dental implant surgery, very advanced technology. So what is a dental implant? So I will show you a dental implant first. So here is a tooth. Here is a model in which you can see. This is this portion. You can see this screw, this portion, the metallic thing. This is an implant. So the person had a missing tooth. The implant looks something like this. You can see here the metallic thing is implant. Okay, so about dental implant. So why do we require them? If suppose a person has a missing teeth, and what are the options to close that space? If a person has lost their missing teeth due to trauma or due to any caries or due to any disease or anything, they have lost the teeth, there is empty space there, then in that situation you can go for a permanent treatment. That permanent treatment is a dental implant. So the dental implant, they are made up of titanium. The metal which a dental implant is made up of is titanium. Titanium is an element or a metal which completely fuses with the bone, and it is bioinert. So this does not have any energy with your bone, with your body, and it does not have any reaction to your body. Many patients, when they come to me, they fear from going for dental implant because they think that there is something extra or something external going on into our body. So will it react with the body? So I would like to say that no, dental implants do not react with your body, because they are made up of titanium material. They are bio inert. So after placing the dental implant inside the bone, the dental implant make like your tooth root. Like your tooth has a root portion and a crown portion through which you chew, the dental implant is same like your tooth root portion. Above that, after placing the dental implant, after the dental implant completely integrates with your bone, fuses with your bone, you get permanent crowns like this. So you can see above the dental implant there are permanent crowns placed. So the dental implant, as I told you, yes, you can get if there is a missing tooth. So next question is from Mr. Uday Reddy. Root canal is compulsory, want to do? Yes, if it is compulsory, if the doctor has advised you root canal, then yes, you should go for it. If you do not go for it, if you avoid it, then the infection of your tooth increases more and more, and along with spreading to other tooth, it also eats up your bone. It lead to other consequences which can be more severe. The most severe consequences can be osteomyelitis. Osteomyelitis means inflammation or infection of your bone. So in such situation, if you have any tooth which can be treated with the root canal, please get it treated. Otherwise, it can lead into many other severe complications. Mr. Amayaka has again asked me another question. Only top jaw, teeth are front. Ease can I control without wearing clips? Yes, without wearing clips, you can control them. If they are front, they can be brought back. Yes, they can be brought back with the help of aligners. These aligners, as I showed you, these are the aligners in which you do not need to wear the clips. You have to just wear this removable aligners. Okay. Mr. Uday Reddy has asked me a question. Sometime mouth smell also will come. Yes, Mr. Uday, if you have oral odor problem, then you can visit a doctor, you can visit a dentist, or you can come to our clinic. Basically, the reason, main reason why it happens is because of calculus or plaque accumulation. Because of that only, usually there is mouth odor problem, and it is not at all good for your oral health. You should get it cleaned as early as possible. So, coming to another question, blood from your teeth. Yes, as I told you, bleeding from your teeth are again due to accumulation of plaque or calculus. Get them treated, or in more severe cases, it may be due to your loss of attachment of your gums. If loss of attachment is there of your gum from the teeth and they are more extensive, then you have to go for something called as flap surgery. What is a flap surgery? If maybe many of the viewers must have heard this term, flap surgery. What is a flap surgery? The flap surgery is nothing. Do not be afraid of it. If your teeth have lost the attachment, if you feel too much sensitivity from your teeth, if your roots are exposed, then you can go for a flap surgical procedure. In flap surgical procedure, the gums are repositioned to the tooth where they were supposed to be. Now, because of debris and infection, the gums have lost their contact. They have receded from their contact. So, in flap surgical procedure, the gums are repositioned for their original position. Mr. Amayaka has again asked me another question. My mother one teeth removed before 6 months. Now, which suits her to fill that place? If your mother has got only one tooth removed before 6 months, and you can go for implant. Yes, you can go for implant, but before going for implant, you have to visit us, because we need to see how much bone is available in that area, because after seeing the bone, how much is available, we can tell you whether we can go for an implant or not. If you can go for an implant after advice of the doctor, then implant will be a permanent solution for your mother. Ms. Satyaprabha has asked me to fill the teeth gap. What is the dental treatment for age group 34? To fill the teeth gap, if the gap is not very big, if the gap are 0.5 mm or 1 mm, if you do not want any orthodontic treatment, then you can go for smile designing, or you can go for composite filling of the gaps or the midline, the gaps, whatever are present, they can be filled with a tooth colored material. They are filled in such a way that it cannot be made, nobody can appreciate that you have got a filling done there. These are for minor gaps. And if you want, if the gap is too big, if the gap is very big, it cannot be filled by filling material, then you can go for smile designing. As I told you, you can go for crown placements of above the tooth, or you can go for orthodontic or braces treatment of the tooth, or you can go for the best one nowadays available with us is aligners, because they are not visible, you aesthetically they are very pleasing, and they exert the same pressure as the braces. So, and one more thing I want to clear, that patient, some patient will ask me that I am above 30. So, can I go for orthodontic treatment or not? So, I would like to tell them that orthodontic treatment can be done at 30 years of age also, at 40 years of age also. It depends on, again, it depends on your bone situation. If your bone are strong enough, if your bone are compact enough, then yes, you can go for orthodontic treatment. Even if you are 30 years, 34 years, you can go for an orthodontic treatment to close your gaps.
Mr. Naveen Kumar has asked me, if I brush twice per day but my tooth getting decay, could you say the reason please and remedy? Mr. Naveen, if you brush your teeth twice per day, still you are getting tooth caries. So there may be two reasons. First common reason is accumulation of debris, plaque or calculus, because of which your mouth is a nest for the bacteria to flourish there. Because of that, you are very prone to caries. Second reason, some people are genetically very prone to caries. It is very common in some people. In such people who are very prone to caries, those people should frequently have a dental checkup to be done. Prophylactic measures should be taken to prevent them. And if possible, they should go for fluoride application also, which is a process in which fluoride is an element if we apply to the tooth, the teeth become resistant for a time being for the caries. So you can go for fluoride application also. But prophylactic measures are always the best. Do not let the caries happen. Do not wait till that time. Get the prophylactic or preventive measure. Prophylactic means preventive. Get the preventive measures done before the consequences happen. Now coming to another question. Mr. Uday has asked me, sometime paining also will come after cool water is taken. Okay, I understood your question. You mean that when you take or drink or eat anything very cold, or you have sensitivity. Okay, so the sensitivity, if it is in a particular tooth, then it can be due to caries related to that tooth. That means you are having some infection into that tooth. That is why you are having sensitivity, or when you eat or drink anything very hot or very cold. Okay. And if it is generalized sensitivity, that means your root portion is exposed. The crown portion of a tooth has a layer called enamel. When this layer of enamel is lost, then you feel sensitivity. Or else, if your root portion of the tooth, root portion means the inner portion which is supposed to be hidden by the gums, if that is exposed, then you will have sensitivity. In that situation, you have to go for gum repositioning for permanent solution of your teeth, so that you do not have that sensitivity problem. Mr. Sheikh has asked me, ma'am, I have already done the final filling, but also my teeth is paining. Mr. Sheikh, if even after doing the filling your teeth is paining, there can be two reasons. First, you need to tell me how long back the filling was done. Is it recent or is it many years back? Second, if you still have the pain, then you should visit a doctor, visit a dental clinic, so that they can take an x-ray and they can check the tooth again. Is there any secondary caries or is there any secondary infection? Okay, if there is any secondary infection below that filling, then the filling has to be removed, and the filling has to be, after removing, the infection has to be removed again, and then again the filling has to be refilled. This is the treatment plan. Okay, Mr. Sheikh has explained 2 months ago he has got the filling done. So if till 2 months you were absolutely fine, and if after 2 months suddenly you are having pain into that tooth, then that means there is some residual infection definitely there. You have to get an x-ray done so that the doctor can tell, after seeing the x-ray, if there is any residual caries or infection there. That is why you are getting pain. Bad breath from mouth, Ms. Satyaprabha has asked, bad breath from mouth indicates any infection in our body? Yes. If there is bad breath from mouth, usually it is due to oral conditions only. But if other than oral condition, if there are any condition, generalized condition, yes, it can be. It depends on many systemic situation, and bad breath can be in people with renal or kidney problems. They also have bad breath. A particular fruity smell or odor will come. Or it can also be due to It can also be due to diabetic patient. Diabetic patient will also have a particular kind of bad breath. Or most common problem, as I told you, is due to oral problems only, oral debris. Or else, other than that, many people will have problem due to ENT problems also. In your throat, sometimes what happens is that some pouches form in which the food goes and lodges there. So this is the worst situation. These are, I'm telling you, the things which can happen due to which bad breath can happen. I'm telling you that it is not necessary that each and every person can have an ENT situation or a renal problem. It can be due to simple oral problems also. But if you are asking me, then there can be an ENT or throat problem also, in which there are pouches will form. They are genetically or by birth in some people, or in some people after some age they form, in which the food gets lodged again and again, and due to which the patient will feel that they have bad breath. So that can be treated, the generalized or the other body problem have to be treated by specialist of that particular body or organ. Or if there is an oral problem, then that is treated by a dentist. Now Sheikh, Mr. Sheikh Manan has told me that his root canal was not done properly. Yes, Mr. Sheikh, may be possible that root canal was not done properly, or there is any secondary caries, or the root canal was not filled properly, or you did not go for crown. I have seen many patients after going for root canal, they do not opt for crown. I would like to tell you that if you have undergone a root canal, and if it is required, if a doctor is telling you that it is required for you to wear a crown, then yes, you should wear a crown. Why? Because a crown or a cap over a tooth after root canal, it acts as a barrier. It acts as a shield so that there is no secondary infection again going. Sorry for interruption. I was telling about the cap. Yes. So why it is required? It acts as a shield or it acts as a barrier so that further any infection does not go into the root canal treated tooth. Because once the tooth is root canal treated, there are chances that if you leave it spare without any cap or like that only, then it can again land up into secondary infection. Or after root canal, usually the tooth becomes little weak. So to save it from any further damage, we advise that if it is required, we advise you a cap or a crown. You should go for it if it is advised. So I think I have solved Mr. Sheikh's problem, the question. So now coming to another surgical topic, this would be my last surgical topic which I will be discussing with you today. Another problem which I have seen in patients very commonly is frenum. High frenum. What is a high frenum? So I would like to show you few photos of high frenum. Some patients will have a gap in between front teeth, and that gap does not close even after they undergo orthodontic treatment or any aligner or anything. That is called a high frenum. So why does it happen? I will show you a photo of a high frenum, what it is and how it can be treated if there is a midline gap. So here you can see in this photo, in between the two teeth, you can see in between the two front teeth, you can see there is a band, thick band of tissue. This thick band of tissue is present in every person, but in few cases it will be present very lower from its original position. Like here you can see it is present in between the two teeth. So there is a very thick band of tissue due to which the gap is not closing. The gap does not close naturally, due to which this thick tissue is called as frenum. So if any person has such problem in which they have a gap in between two teeth, and they visit a doctor, because recently I have seen one or two of my patients who had the same problem, and I explained to them that it can be treated with a simple procedure. What is the simple procedure to treat such situation of high frenum or the thick band of tissue in between two teeth? The simple procedure is that just reposition the frenum, reposition the two teeth, reposition the thick tissue above from the where it is supposed to be, so that it does not hamper the movement of the two teeth. So I'll show you. Here you can see the first photo. Here it shows you, the first photo it shows you that there is a thick band of tissue, and the second photo it shows you after treatment the gap is closed completely after repositioning the frenum. Here you can see. So it is very simple surgical procedure. We just reposition the tissue to little higher level so that they do not hamper the movement of the two teeth and the two teeth close naturally. This is called frenectomy. This procedure is called frenectomy. This frenum is present in between the upper two teeth and also in the tongue, below the tongue. I will show you one photo of a small boy with a, you can see here, you can see in this photo there is a frenum below the tongue and it is very forwardly placed. Because of this, a situation called as tongue tie happens. Tongue tie means because of the frenum very forwardly placed, the speech is slurred. The person or the child is not able to speak properly, and there is continuous pull of that frenum. So it again and again it damages the tissue also. So again, a simple procedure for that is yes, you can go for a small surgical procedure in which they reposition the frenum to a correct position so that the tongue tie, the tie is removed. So if any of the person has a high frenum in which the frenum is hampering the movement of the teeth, or if the frenum is causing the tongue to tie, then you can go for small surgical procedure and you can get it treated. Do not be afraid of it. Again, another question is again about bad breath. Yes, bad breath can be treated by cleaning or scaling. Mr. Uday has asked me a question from tongue side and up, some wound will cause come, I am suffering pain. Can you answer? From tongue side and up, some wound will come. Okay, I understood what you are trying to ask. From tongue side and up, the wound which you are which is again and again, I suppose it comes again and again in your tongue, that is called that is an ulcer. Okay, that is called, if it is recurrent, it is called an aphthous ulcer. What is an aphthous ulcer? It is a name, aphthous is a name given for that type of ulcer. That is usually because of nutritional deficiency, any nutritional deficiency, or usually it is because of undergoing any stress. So in that situation, if you have any wound, usually they are very small, but they are recurrent. If you are continuously undergoing any stress or any trauma is there and continuously, or you have any nutritional deficiency, in that situation you have that recurrent small ulcers. In that situation, if it is due to nutritional deficiency, you can go for a course of vitamin B capsules. Or if it is due to stress, the aphthous ulcer resolve by itself in some 7 to 10 days. And you can visit a dentist for that. They advise you some gels. There come some gels which numb the area of that ulcer and they help in healing the ulcer faster. So you can visit a doctor, you can visit us, you can come to us so that we can advise you proper medications for your wound. Mr. Ankit has asked me, most of the time it bleeds while brushing up to teeth. What to do? Mr. Ankit, I would like to say, if it is bleeding while brushing, then most common cause is accumulation of debris, or there is infection in your gums, that is due to accumulation of debris or plaque, which is called plaque or calculus. You have to visit our dentist or visit us, and you have to undergo a scaling or cleaning procedure, generalized cleaning of your teeth, So that helps in reducing the bleeding of your gums, and so they help in healing of your gums. Fixing, Mr. Sachin has asked me, fixing a cap in one teeth in front upper jaw. that depends, Mr. Sachin, what cap you are choosing. We have, in Partha Dental, we have different types of cap or crown available with us. It depends on what type of cap or crown you are choosing. There are certain type of cap which are metallic. Completely they are made up of metal. Or we have also option of caps which are porcelain fused with metal. Or we also have option of zirconia crowns. Completely they are made up of zirconia lava, or they completely mimic like your tooth in your color, in your resistance. They are almost similar to your tooth. So it depends what type of cap you choose for your upper front tooth. Ms. Abhiruchi has asked me, wisdom tooth pain, doctor, what to do? Ms. Abhiruchi, yes, if you have a wisdom tooth pain, then you can visit us, you can come to us. We will check you. After checking, we will take an x-ray of that concerned area so that we can find out if the wisdom tooth is covered with bone or there is space available in the wisdom tooth to erupt. If the space is available for the tooth to erupt, we will go for a non-surgical procedure in which we just remove the hindrance, or above the whatever gum is hindering it, we just cut remove that much gum portion. And if in a situation in which there, it is completely it is covered with bone, then we have to extract the tooth surgically. Mr. Vankayalapati has asked me a question that he has both teeth and bone proclination. He advised clip treatment and surgery, which is first. If a doctor has advised you clip treatment and surgery, so if you ask me which is first, if I go into detail, so I would like to tell you, if your both of your teeth are proclined, if both upper and lower jaws are proclined, in that means that nature has compensated. There is a phenomena, there is a very natural thing. Nature compensates or try to hide all the flaws in every creature. So when there is something in which nature has compensated your teeth, suppose if your only upper jaw are they have bone proclination, or suppose both of the jaw have bone proclination, but both of them also have teeth proclination, then yes, I would like to say that you should go for the doctor treatment plan should be that they should go for clip treatment first. They should be decompensated first. The natural compensation should be removed first. They should be decompensated first, and then after some time you should go for surgical procedure. So if you have visited the dentist, you can go with them as they have advised, or if you have any further doubts, you can visit us also for orthognathic surgery and for orthognathic procedures. For clip treatment also, we have all the facilities available here. For orthognathic surgeries also, you can come to us. We can explain you better, and we can give you the whatever treatment is required for you. So I have explained you many surgical and non-surgical procedures. It was a lot of questions had come to me. It was very nice talking to you guys, and I hope after listening to all whatever I have told, I have cleared few doubts of you people. I hope that there is one more question. Okay, Mr. Uday has told me about a hospital and about a doctor that to clean your teeth daily, do some doubt is there. Now you clarify my doubt. Yes, you should clean your teeth if it is required. If there is any plaque or calculus accumulation, yes, you should clean your teeth if doctor has advised you. I think she must have advised you correct only. Yes, you should clean your teeth if it is required, and every 6 to 8 months you should visit a doctor, visit a dentist, and you should get your cleaning or scaling. of teeth because it is good for your oral health. Your oral health reflects your general health. If your oral health is good, your oral health is connected to your body health. The bacteria in your mouth can go to other body organs also and they can lead to other health problem also. So yes, if you need cleaning, then you should go for cleaning. You should not be afraid of any such procedure. So as I was saying, I discussed with you a few surgical and non-surgical topics in this much of time duration. So I hope it has helped all of you. I hope that now onwards you will not be afraid of dental procedures. You will not be scared of dental procedures. And even if after that you have doubt, anything, if you have any problem, you can discuss with us. You can come to our clinic. You can visit Partha Dental Clinic. And do not worry, dental procedures are not as scary as you feel. There are many myths and rumors because of which patient will not undergo procedure, they will skip it. So don't skip it. If it is required, please go for the treatment. And if you have any habits, as I discussed few conditions about habits also, like if you have any habits of tobacco, any habit of smoking, any habit of paan, gutka, chewing and all, please leave all these. These are not good for your oral health and for your general health also. So after saying all these things, I would like to conclude my video. Thank you all of you for watching and listening to me with so much patience. If you have any other doubts, you can visit to us. You can visit us on our website, www.parthadental.com. This is our official website. You can ask us questions. There is an online chat option available. You can ask to us online, and you can also ask toll-free. You can call us. Then the number is 1-800-102-8686. I will repeat it, 1-800-102-8686. So this is a toll free number. You can call on us and you can ask questions. And there is also a WhatsApp number. You can WhatsApp us, 8500-779-000. 8500-779-000. You can WhatsApp us on this number. And if you do not remember these numbers, you can always visit our website, www.parthadental.com. You can visit us on that. And you can ask us, you can take an appointment also online. We have option of taking appointment online. We are available on Facebook, we are available on WhatsApp, we are available on Twitter. On all social medias we are available. We are available to help you, your problems for all patients. So if you have any problem, please visit us. Okay, so thank you very much. Thank you all of you for watching me. Thanks a lot. Bye.